The most popular license plate in New Mexico features a red and green chili pepper and proclaims New Mexico as the chili capital of the world. According to the Chile Pepper Institute at New Mexico State University, Chile is a $250 million industry, and New Mexico is this nation's premier producer of hot chili peppers. The growing season is longer in southern New Mexico, where the temperature stays hotter. So 75% of the state's chili comes from Doña Ana, Luna, and Hidalgo counties. It is believed that chili found its way to New Mexico with the Spanish colonists in 1598, when their Tlaxcalan Mexican Indian servants brought the seeds with them. Another theory is that the New Mexico Pueblo Indians traded produce with the Toltec Indians of Mexico, and that's how the seeds made it into the state. Either scenario is plausible, but what is certain is that from the first encounter between Europeans and Native Americans to the present, Chile has been the ideal mediator between people and culture. According to the Chile Pepper Institute, chili peppers originated in the lowlands of Brazil, where birds developed a symbiotic relationship with the peppers. Unlike mammals, birds don't have receptors in their mouths, so they don't taste the heat of the chili. The bird's digestive tract is also unaffected by the heat, which makes them the perfect vessel to sow the seeds of the chili peppers. Birds consume them with no adverse effects, and as they fly around pooping, they're planting chili. The South American chili pepper is a type of fruit, not a vegetable. With the help from birds, the fruits made its way to Central America between 5200 and 3400 BC and slowly crept up into Mexico. The peppers were introduced to the rest of the world by Christopher Columbus. The explorer brought chili peppers back to Spain, where their popularity quickly spread to the rest of Europe, followed by Africa and Asia. When Columbus sampled chili for the first time, the heat emanating from the fruit reminded him of black pepper, and that's where they got the name chili pepper. In the old days, during the autumn season, the people of New Mexico would string their chilies together to dry them for the upcoming winter. The hanging chilies became known as chili ristras. Today, ristras have become a ubiquitous tradition that defines Santa Fe and New Mexico culture, and can be seen adorning hotels, businesses, and homes throughout the state. Commercial dehydrators are now used for commercial red chili processing. By the end of summer, ristras mixed with red and green chili start appearing at the local farmers' markets. Green and red chili come from the same plant. Just like green apples turn red in the autumn, so does New Mexico green chili. New Mexico's green chili season is mid-August through mid-October. That's when los chileros, the roadside chili vendors, begin to appear. From El Paso all the way up through New Mexico until you reach Denver, chili roasters dot the landscape. Even Whole Foods and other supermarkets sell green chili. Today, the chili merchants roast the chili for you. In the old days, in the 1980s, you had to roast chili in your own oven at home. It took forever, but your house smelled wonderful. I always wait until the end of the chili season when the peppers are turning colors. A chili dish made with green, orange, and red makes for an aesthetically pleasing and delicious dish. Chili companies refer to the fall harvest as autumn roast. The old-timers call it chile pintado, or painted chili. When you get your roasted chili home, it needs to cool to room temperature. Then you're ready to place batches of fresh green chili into freezer bags so that you'll have enough chili to get you to the next season. Just about everyone in New Mexico has a second freezer just for chili. And all the supermarkets throughout the state have a special section just for New Mexico chili. The small chili pepper known as chili piquin, as in picoso or very hot, is also grown in New Mexico. The rule of chili is that the smaller the chili, the hotter the chili. Capsaicin is the active ingredient in chili that produces heat to the nerve endings. The heat releases endorphins that act as natural opiates in the human body. Many people claim that this sensation is addicting, and that's why they continue to crave chili. The more capsaicin, the hotter the pepper. The chili industry uses the Scoville units to quantify capsaicin in each pepper. The Scoville unit was created by Wilbur Lincoln Scoville. He was an American pharmacist working for Parke Davis Pharmaceutical when he devised the Scoville test in 1912, the year New Mexico became the 47th state. Virtually all red chili is processed. The best way to make red chili, the only way I make it, like any good cook in New Mexico, is with the chili pods, not the powder. The pods can be purchased at any local supermarket. Once you take off the stem and empty out the seeds, you soak the chili in hot water for at least 45 minutes. Then you puree the chili in a food processor, adding fresh garlic and salt. The rich chili paste can be used on its own as a vegetarian dish or to marinate pork, beef, chicken, or even tofu. If you're making Frito pies or enchiladas, any dish that has a lot of competing flavors, then the chili powder will suffice. But if the red chili is the highlight of the meal, then you won't mind going through the extra work of pureeing the pods. The old timers referred to this type of chili as Chile Caribe, but I call it the single malt scotch of red chili. You'll find this recipe and 489 more in A Cultural Convergence Cookbook.